Welcome back to Sister Circle Live again. As we continue our All About Health Week, we are taking a look at some of the biggest health issues that women face. Here to answer some of our most pressing questions concerning our health issues is Dr. Katina.
Hello.
Welcome to the circle.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you for having us,
Dr. Katina. Now, Dr. Katina, one of the questions that I have is, it says that we should know our health status, and you refer to it as the big three, the BCB. Mm. Explain what you mean by that, the big three.
Yes, so I have a Know Your Health Status campaign on social media, and I do that because preventative care is key, and the big three is blood pressure, cholesterol, and blood sugar. Ooh. That's the big three. You know how you go to your financial institution and you know you see your notifications come in and you know what's going in and out of your bank account?
Yes.
It's the same thing. You need to know what's going on the inside of your body.
Right.
So it's important for you to know your blood pressure, cholesterol, and blood sugar. Also, in knowing your health status, getting your physical exams done.
Yes.
When you get your physical exam done, we check your blood and it checks for thyroid disorders.
Yep.
And the thyroid disorders are very common in women.
They are.
We also check your blood for anemia. Iron deficient anemia is common as well. So it's important in knowing your health status because preventative care. Oh, good. Definitely important to know your health status because prevention is key. You can actually prevent yourself from acquiring chronic disorders by knowing what's going on the inside of your body.
Absolutely. Right. Speaking of knowing your status, what are the most important screenings as women we should be getting?
Definitely your pap smears.
Mm-hmm. All right.
So if you haven't had your pap smears, you get that done, ladies.
Yes.
The pap smears are important because they check for cervical cancer.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
It also checks for solid infections that we may have, such as bacterial vaginosis or yeast infections, which are very common in women. Mm-hmm. Also silent STDs. Mm-hmm. Such as gonorrhea, chlamydia, and trichomonas.
Mm-hmm.
So your pap smears, your pelvic exams. Also, when we do the pelvic exam, we check for any fibroids that may be present or enlargement of the uterus or pain. And if we find that those abnormalities, then we'll do an ultrasound, and that checks for ovarian cancer, which is a very, very poor prognosis when it's later diagnosed.
Yes.
So it's important to get your ultrasound, your pelvic exams, your mammograms.
Yes.
Get your mammograms done. And also, do your self-breast exams once a month. All right, do it about 1 week after your period. Mm-hmm. Check your breasts. You want to make sure that you don't feel anything, any lumps.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, we know that we need to do that once a month, but what about daily? Mm-hmm. Are there any supplements we should be taking, you know, just so we're like, okay, I need this for my blood pressure. I need this for whatever ailment's going on. So what should we do daily?
Yes, daily supplements that I recommend is prenatal vitamin.
Oh,
you know, a lot of my patients, they're like, wait a minute, I'm not prepared for pregnancy.
Yeah, I take those.
But it's actually a good vitamin that women can take.
Mm-hmm.
It's over the counter. You don't have to, you know, have the prescription, but it's good for our hair, our nails, our skin. We have energy. Just think back when you were, you know, pregnant, or if you were pregnant, you felt great. You looked great.
Mm-hmm. Well, Dr. Katina, I tried. Listen, my God, and, you know, my God, baby, she's so precious. But so her mom gave me some of her prenatal vitamins, right? She said, okay, quiet. You just take this, girl. You're good. I tried to take them, and I got sick every single time. Did I do something? They are huge. Did I do something wrong?
Sometimes you do have to try different ones.
And I know I wasn't supposed to take anybody else's medicine.
Yeah,
I know that. But I did. But I did. So what happened with me in that?
Yeah, sometimes you do have to, you know, play with different ones and just see which one works best for your body.
Yeah.
Also taking it with food. Sometimes taking it at the end of the day could help as well.
Okay.
So
I think I just woke up and was like, oh, you know,
let me take
this prenatal vitamin that I got from my good girlfriend.
So prenatal vitamins, omega-3 fish oil is important. It's good for the brain and heart health. Your vitamin D. We are very, very low in vitamin D. That's important. It's good for bone health, your breast health, breast cancer, and overall mood in general.
Mm-hmm.
So that vitamin D is important.
Well, we as women, we often take care of everyone else first, and we always leave ourselves for last. And sometimes we often don't even get to ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think we should be doing on the day-to-day basis just for self-care?
Mm-hmm. Yes. And in general, women, we're so responsible for a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm.
We're leaders, entrepreneurs. But I tell people, in order to carry out your passion and your purpose, you have to take care of self first.
Absolutely.
That's very important. So getting your sleep.
Mm-hmm.
I hope you all get your sleep, ladies.
That's real talk.
Uh-huh. Yes.
You must get about 6 to 8 hours of sleep a night. Okay. Also, exercise. You want to get in 20 minutes of exercise a day. Mm-hmm. All right. Also, drink your water. 8 glasses of water a day is good for your skin. Mm-hmm. It's good for the intestinal system. A lot of women suffer from constipation, so it helps with that. And also, just getting sleep and just having me time. Mm-hmm. That's important.
And eating healthy. So, you said something about meals earlier.
Yes, yes. No skipping your meals, especially for those who are interested in weight loss. Skipping your meals. Yeah. You want to get your breakfast snack, lunch snack, dinner snack on board and eat healthy and have me time. Me time is so important. We have to go and relax. Go get a pedicure away from everybody else. Go meditate. Listen to music. Mm. Get a massage. We have to de-stress, ladies.
De-stress and take out.
Speaking of stress, what can we do if we're feeling depressed or feeling anxious? What's the best thing to do? What's the best go-to?
So the first thing to do is definitely to recognize it. That's important. Recognize your feelings and act on your feelings as well. And go get help. See a psychologist, psychiatrist, and get help because mental is so important, as important as physical. Mm-hmm. So don't be ashamed to ask for help and delegate your task as well.
Well, Dr. Katina, we thank you so much for being with us.
Yes, we do.
Oh, you're welcome.
We can just talk to y'all for the rest of the day and
tomorrow. I know. We have so much to talk about.
We have to talk to our people out there in the world. So stay with us. And what the people say is up next.